Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyana Muhammad wa ala alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'da habita fillah. We've talked about this countless times, the importance of avoiding ghiba and namima, of avoiding backbiting and slandering people. And every time I mention this, it's a reminder for myself first and foremost. So I'd like to remind myself and my brothers and sisters in Islam of the importance of avoiding this major sin. It's a major sin, but it's so easy to do. Subhanallah, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned, and we'll mention that hadith perhaps. But first I'd like to mention this ayah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitabi al-kareem, وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا وَلَا يَغْتَبُ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا أَيُّهِبُّ أَهْدَكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكَلَ اللَّحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرَحْتَمُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ تُوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hujurat, and do not spy on one another, and do not backbite one another. Would one of you like that to eat the flesh of your dead brother? For verily you would hate it, so fear Allah. Verily Allah is Tawwab Rahim. Verily Allah is the most, the acceptor of repentance, and the most merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this ayah, the habita fillah, it shows us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates backbiting. So we should hate backbiting. And that backbiting is a major sin. It also shows us something else which is very important, and that is not to spy. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, لا تجاسسوا ولا تحاسدوا ولا تباغضوا ولا تضابروا وكنوا عباد الله إخوانا. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said in an authentic hadith, I believe it's in Bukhari, possibly in Bukhari and Muslim, ولا تجاسسوا ولا تحاسدوا ولا تباغضوا ولا تضابروا, that you should not spy upon one another, you should not hate one another, you should not have hasid, envy. Do not be envious of one another, and do not turn your backs upon one another, and be brothers in Islam. That ayat and that hadith show us the importance of avoiding backbiting. And when you think about the hatred that we have for one another, wa'iyadhan billah, and that some of us receive honor and find it honorable and find it pleasurable to belittle their brothers and sisters in Islam. And I want to address Ahl Sunnah specifically, that sometimes between Ahl Sunnah there are issues where people differ, and the enmity that results from it is unbefitting for a mu'min, is unbefitting for a believer. And it is unbefitting for someone from Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah to backbite, to slander, to lie, to have hatred and enmity, to spy, and to envy their brothers and sisters in Islam, a mu'min in general, and even non-Muslims, and more specifically, their brothers and sisters from Ahl Sunnah. So beware of those people who go around looking at people's web pages and at people's YouTube pages and at people's Facebook pages, and they spend all of their time looking for mistakes of individuals and statements of individuals in order to make a video about them, in order to curse them, in order to slander them, in order to belittle and bring them down. Beware of those individuals. That does not mean that we do not take dalil or take evidence that someone has gone astray from their statements. That's not what we're saying. But we're talking about those people who make it their business to do such things and to spread fitna between their brothers and sisters, and to spread hatred between their brothers and sisters, and who do it unlawfully, not with a sharia maqsad, not with a sharia purpose or intention, but rather in order to make themselves big, belittle their brother or sister in Islam, or just to spread fitna and fasad throughout the land. So this reminds me of the hadith, which it becomes necessary to mention because it's so relevant to this discussion. And it's a hadith I believe it's muttafaqun alayh in Bukhari and Muslim. Marra an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala qabrayn faqal إنهما ليعذبان وما يعذبان في كبير أما أحدهما فكان لا يستتر من البول وأما الآخر فكان يمشي بالنميمة فأخذ جريدة رطبة فشقها نصفين فغرز في كل قبر واحد فقال يا رسول الله لما فعلت هذا قال لعله يخفف عنهما ما لم يبسا رواه مسلم, if I'm correct. In this hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, which is relevant, absolutely relevant for our discussion, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, was walking by some graves, and there were graves of some Jews, as it was mentioned in another narration. And he said, verily they're being punished, and they're being punished for something which the people think is light, meaning the people don't think it's a big deal. And then he said, as for one of them, he used to not be careful with regards to his urinating. And may Allah protect us and forgive us of our many mistakes and not being cautious in those things. وَعِيَاذٍ بِاللَّهِ. And may Allah protect us and forgive us for that. As for the other one, فَكَانَ يَمْشِ بِالنَّمِيمَةِ. As for the second one, is they used to spread wicked tales around the community, meaning spreading stories, even if it might be true, with the intent of spreading facade. They want to spread wickedness. They want controversy. They love it. Some people feed off that, and we all know them. We all know people who fall into this trait. وَعِيَاذٍ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. It shows us, Ahabati Fillah, it's a major sin to backbite, and a major sin to slander, and a major sin to have namima. And that it is not a characteristic, obviously, from the mu'mineen. And it is not a characteristic from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And it is not a characteristic from the Salafiyun. Because that which Yantasabila Salaf, that which adheres to the Minhaj of the Salaf, or is associated with the Minhaj of the Salaf, comes with khair only. It only comes with good. So the one who does this and makes it their business to destroy people's character, I mean, that's their business, meaning that's what they pride themselves in doing. They do that, and their intent is not to help the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their intent is not to spread khair, then those individuals are individuals of a wicked characteristic that we must strive our best to be away from and to avoid. And to know that they are committing a major sin. And may Allah protect us and forgive us of our many, many sins and from having those characteristics. Anything I said that was correct from Allah Azza wa Jalla, anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.